Highly skilled workers in the southeastern Ontario city of Trenton are recreating the past, the prehistoric past to be precise. Joining us now to explain from our studio at Queen's University in Kingston, our Eastern Ontario Hub editor, David Rockne Corrigan. Welcome.
Jan, hello.
Now, David, you recently had a chance to visit the unique facility in Trenton, which is found in Eastern Ontario. The company is called Research Casting International, and it builds dinosaurs for museums around the world. Let's take a quick look at how it does what it does.
How it all starts is you have a person walking through the Badlands who find a little scrap of bone, and that little scrap of bone, you follow it all the way up to where the bone layer is. If it's a good specimen, wrap it up in a plaster block, and then pull the plaster block out of the ground. The plaster jackets come here, and then what we do is prepare out the fossil. Once the fossil is prepared out, then we take molds off the fossil. If the fossil's not complete, we reconstruct it, we mold it. We take molds, we paint on an RTV silicone rubber, make an impression of the bone, both sides, pull the rubber off, then we have a mold, then we cast into the mold, and then we assemble the skeleton, and then once we're finished here, it goes into a museum and it's there for another 50 years.
So we can see from that video, quite extensive. Now, this place has built more than 700 skeletons over the past 30 years, which I imagine, again, involves quite the team, as you can see from there. What are the different skills involved in putting together one of these exhibits?
It's a spectrum of skills that they've got here. As a museum technical services company, they specialize in dino skeletons, as you see there. And so, you know, to mount them, they have metal workers and blacksmiths, and they have artists and people who, you know, create them the molds for the casting that then get put on the mount. So there's a whole range of skills that are at play here, and it's the intersection of art and history and science and design. So it was quite neat to see that in person, and I will admit that it definitely inspired the inner child in me.
Now, in that footage that we've shown, it doesn't show the latest massive undertaking that's kept staff busy there. Tell us about Zuul.
So Zuul, Kuravastator, is a 75 million year old specimen that was discovered in Montana in 2014. And it's a newly discovered species of ankylosaur. Ankylosaurs, for those who don't remember back to grade 3, are armored dinosaurs. This particular one would have been about 6 meters long, about the length of a pickup truck. It would have been, you know, slightly shorter than a human being, and it was, you know, horned, and it had a big tail club, and would have been a dangerous beast.
What's the story behind that name? For our viewers, it's spelled Zuul. Tell me the story behind that.
Right. So, you know, one of the perks of discovering a new species is that you get to name it. So David Evans and Victoria Arbor, who made the discovery, decided to name it Zuul after the similar looking monster in Ghostbusters, the movie Ghostbusters. You can picture a short snout and horns. If you haven't seen the movie, you'll just have to take my word that there's a resemblance there. So that's the first part, Zuul. And then the second part's interesting too, which is Kuravastator, and that means destroyer of shins. So they're referring to that the big tail club it has as a somewhat tongue-in-cheek there as the destroyer of shins. So it's kind of a fun name, and it would have been fun to come up with it, I'm sure.
Tell me about what makes Zuul's discovery so unique.
Right. Well, so there's a couple of things. I mean, just the way that it was found is interesting. So in 2014, they were doing a dig for another dinosaur, a Gorgosaurus, in Montana, just south of the Alberta border, and almost by accident they found Zuul. So they hit this fossil with a skid loader and thought, hey, what's this? And so they realized that it was not just, you know, a specimen of an ankylosaur, but it was one of the best preserved specimens of an ankylosaur that has ever been found anywhere in the world. So right away they knew that they had something unique, and it turned out to be even more special than they realized when they found it.
Now, Zuul is coming to Toronto, to the Royal Ontario Museum, but there's still some work to be done. What kind of work has to get done before it gets here?
Yeah, so if you can imagine, you find this fossil in Montana, and you realize the size of it. So you basically cut a big block around the body of the fossil. This is a 16,000 kilogram, 35,000 pound block that they then removed and is now in Trenton. And what they're doing now is, they cut the whole thing in half. And then they flip the two sides over, and they've been chipping away at this rock to reveal the fossil. So if you go to see this exhibition, which is coming up, you will get to see the fossil within that stone, sort of being revealed in that stone.
When can I see Zuul?
So you're going to want to go to the Royal Ontario Museum after December 15th, Saturday, December 15th, and it'll be running, the exhibit runs until May of 2019. So you do have some time, but it is opening soon.
All right. Always a pleasure, David Rockne Corrigan. Again, you have the article up about meeting Zuul and seeing them put it together. Always a pleasure. Until next time.
Thank you.
The Agenda with Steve Bacon is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario, helping businesses stay on the right side of change with strategic thinking, insightful decisions, and business leadership. Are you on the right side of change? Ask an Ontario CPA.